Welcome to Whiteboard Programming, where we simplify programming with easy to understand whiteboard videos. And today I'll be sharing with you what is SAP PP or SAP Production Planning, and we'll be providing you a brief introduction to it. So let's get started. First off, what is production planning? Well, production planning is the process of aligning demand with manufacturing capacity to create production and procurement schedules for finished products and component materials. In this cycle, SAP PP acts as an important module as it tracks and makes record of manufacturing process flows, for example, the planned and actual cost, and also during the goods movement from the conversion of raw materials to semi-finished goods. Also, do note that SAP PP is an efficient piece of the puzzle as it fully integrates with other SAP modules, to name them SAP SD, MM, QM, FICO and PM, which is also called as plant maintenance. Next, let's discuss about organization structure in SAP PP. So, it's worth noting that in any live production planning module, location of manufacturing plants and storage within the plants should be available in the system. You must be thinking, why is it important? Simply because of the following reasons. Number one, as all production master data is created at the plant level. Number two, all planning activities too are performed at the plant level. Number three, all production confirmation process and related good movements also occur at plant and storage location level. Convinced? Now, as I just stated about master data, let's discuss about the role of master data in SAP PP and how it plays out. Fundamentally, master data is generally static for any company and is very rarely changed depending on the requirement. There are 5 master data to be manipulated in production planning module. Let's look at each one of them one by one. Number 1. The material master contains information on all the materials that a company procures, produces, stores and sells. It uniquely identifies a material master record and hence also a material. Here, materials with the same basic attributes are grouped together and are assigned to a material type such as finished, raw material, etc. It is used in the following processes. Number 1, to purchase materials. Number 2, for goods movement posting such as goods issue or receipt in inventory management and also for physical inventory postings. Number 3, in invoice verification for posting invoices. Number 4, in sales and distribution for sales order fulfillment process. Number 5, in production planning and control for material requirements planning, scheduling and production confirmation processes. Number 2, bill of material or BOM. Fundamentally, a bill of material is a complete, formally structured list of components together with the quantity required to produce the product or assembly. BOMs are used in material requirement planning and production costing, and you can also create up to 99 alternative BOMs for a single product. Further, for products having variants, you can create Super BOM, which has all possible types of components used to manufacture different types of variants, and the appropriate component is selected based on the characteristic chosen in sales order. For example, product cycle can contain all types of frames with different colors and sizes, and desired frame is selected in the production order based on the color and size chosen in the sales order. Number 3. Work center. A work center is a machine or a group of machines where production operations are performed. They are used in task list operations or routings and contains the data for scheduling, capacity and costing. Number 4. Routing. Routing is nothing but a sequence of operations performed at the work center. It also specifies machine time, labor time, etc. for the execution of operations, and is used for scheduling of operations and plays an important role in standard cost calculation of a product. Number 5. Production version. The production version is a combination of BOM and routing data for production. It is linkage between BOM and routing and determines the manufacturing process. Further, do note that there can be multiple product versions as per different manufacturing process to produce the product. Next, let's have a look at production planning cycle. Fundamentally, the production planning and control consist of two obvious processes of planning and execution. Let's understand them one by one. Number 1. Planning. So, production planning is generally done from budgeted sales plan. Planning is based on the sales plan to meet the sales requirement as per production cycle times, and demand for the product is entered through demand management in the form of planned independent requirement or PIR. This data from demand management becomes the input to material requirement planning or MRP. The MRP checks for the availability of various raw materials used for production at different stages using the master data such as bill of material or BOM and available current plant stock. In the case of material shortage, purchase requisites are created for material which are externally procured and planned orders are created for in-house produced materials. The purchase requisitions and planned orders initiate the procurement cycle and the execution cycle of production respectively. Further, as MRP works with infinite capacities, capacity leveling must be done in order to avoid any capacity bottlenecks. Next, number 2, execution. Here, the discussed plan orders are converted to production orders and are scheduled as per the production timings using master data such as routing. Production orders are released by production supervisor and material availability checks can also be carried out to check if there's any missing component. Further, production is carried out based on the activities maintained in routing where the master data like work center is mentioned against each operation in the routing. Once the production is complete, the confirmation of orders are executed and goods movement for material consumption and goods receipt are posted against the order. Hence, the order gets delivered or DLV status and material is received into desired storage location. Usually at the month end before doing order settlement, production orders need to be set to technically completed status in order to calculate production variances by controlling personnels. Next, let's talk about demand management in SAP PP. The function of demand management is to estimate requirement quantities and delivery dates for finished products and important assemblies. It uses PIR or planned independent requirements and customer requirements for its working. Here, do note that the planning strategies must be defined for a product as they represent the methods of production for planning and manufacturing. There are two methods by which we can usually do this. Number one, make of stock, in which stock is produced independently of orders. Number two, make of orders. This strategy applies to production of material for a specific individual sales order or line item. Next, let's discuss about what is material requirement planning or MRP in SAP PP. So, primarily, MRP determines any shortages and creates appropriate procurement elements in the system, in which it does net requirement calculations and generate planned orders for in-house produced materials and purchase requisitions for raw material. Also, it does lead time scheduling and calculate production dates in planned orders. And lastly, it explores the BOM and generates procurement proposals at each BOM level. Next, let's talk about capacity planning and leveling. So, capacity planning is used to analyze capacity overloads at work centers and shift the orders to avoid any capacity bottlenecks. The capacity requirements are generated via MRP on work center, and since MRP works on infinite capacity and plans everything on work center without considering any capacity constraints, it is required to level the capacity at work center. Lastly, the capacity can be leveled at each work center through planning table in order to create constrained production plan. Next, let's talk about production order. We need to note that the output of MRP will be called as planned orders, which needs to be converted to production orders for further execution of the process. The production order is firm receipt element, which is not affected by MRP run, unlike planned orders. To state simply, production order is a document which specifies what material needs to be produced and in what quantity. It also contains the BOM component and routing operation data to be performed at the work center. And lastly, production order is released for execution and material availability checks can be carried out, which determines if there are any missing components. Next, let's talk about production order confirmation. So, when goods are produced physically at the shop floor, then production order must be confirmed. During confirmation, component materials can be consumed automatically via backflush mechanisms and goods receipt of material can be performed automatically via operation control key in routing. However, instead of auto goods movement, manual good issues and receipt can also be performed separately from confirmation. Do note that any failed good movement due to deficit of component stock can be reprocessed manually. The activity costs such as machine, labor, etc. will also be updated in the production order during confirmation on an actual basis. The respective order gets confirmed or CNF and delivered or DLV status after final confirmation and final good receipts are produced. And do remember that if confirmation is posted wrongly, then we can cancel the confirmation and post it again with the corrected data. Lastly, let's talk about production order close. Now, after the production order is delivered completely, or in case we don't want to execute the order further, then order should be technically completed. After order gets TECO or TECO status, it gets deleted from stock or requirement list and is no longer considered in material requirement planning run. And all the dependent reservations also get deleted from the system. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button, and if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.